Well, there's some new clues into the mystery of the origins of COVID. 3 years after the virus first infected the world, a group of scientists found DNA from an animal known as a raccoon dog. There it is on your screen. That DNA is now linked to the virus. The samples were collected in early 2020 at a seafood market in Wuhan, China, shortly after the first human cases were detected there. This could mean the pandemic originated from an infected animal and not through a lab leak. So joining us now for more insight is Dr. Amesh Adalja, senior scholar at Johns Hopkins Center for Health Security. Dr. Adalja, thank you for your time. All right, so we've heard a lab leak. We've heard a wet market, contaminated bats. Why are we now just hearing about this raccoon dog theory, and does it make sense to you?
Well, this isn't something we've just heard about. Raccoon dogs have been one of the suspected animals that were the link between bats and humans from the very beginning, because raccoon dogs had a similar role with SARS in 2003. What we're hearing about now is some analysis that's been done on the genetics of the virus, as well as what was found in that wet market. And they're seeing that there's raccoon dog DNA in some of the stalls where there also was virus RNA, and that's kind of a linkage. It's something that makes sense. I think it's still not something that's definitive. We don't have an infected animal, and there may be other explanations for it. And again, we're also commenting on something that's been in the press, but hasn't actually been released in an academic medical paper, not even on a preprint server. So a lot of this is speculation because we don't have the full analysis in front of us.
All right, so doctor, speaking of full analysis, we know the genetic samples from this wet market were recently uploaded to an international database, but then removed after scientists asked China about that data. On its face, that certainly seems suspicious, but is there something that maybe the layman just doesn't understand about why the data would have been pulled like that?
Well, this is data that should have been present for several years, and somehow it was posted to a database of genetic sequences, and then it was removed. And I think that really speaks to the lack of transparency from the Chinese government. China doesn't want anyone to figure out the origin of this virus, whether it's either a lab leak or if it's from a wet market. They continue to say that this was something that didn't even originate in China. So this just really speaks to the fact that the Chinese government doesn't want to know the answer to this, no matter what the answer actually is. And what it really also illustrates is that we're going to need transparency and cooperation from the Chinese if we're going to get any kind of definitive answer, and they have been obfuscating from day one.
Absolutely. There's this lack of transparency. Are we likely to ever actually know COVID's origin, and how important is it to science and to humanity that we eventually do get to the bottom of this?
It's unclear if we ever get a definitive answer because, again, it relies upon the Chinese government actually having respect for the truth, and we know that they do not. And if, without that kind of help, unless we get a defector or somebody that gives us information about what was going on in those early days, both in the lab and in the wet market, it's unlikely that we actually get a definitive answer. But I think it is important because this is not the last infectious disease emergency we will face, not the last coronavirus we will face. And if it comes from the wet market, maybe we need to understand what animal it is so that we can change our behavior towards that animal. And if it comes from a laboratory accident, we need to fortify our laboratories that are doing this type of research and making sure it's done at the appropriate biosafety level. Over 6 million people died from this pandemic. I think it's very, very important that we understand how it happened, and that's going to influence future pandemic preparedness.
Absolutely. Yeah, more information is always better than less. All right, Dr. Adalja, thank you. Thank you for watching. Go to newsnationnow.com to find NewsNation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button below to get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.